Okay, it's July 27th, 2016. It's my wife's birthday. The big, well, some people used to say it was a big birthday, you know, when you get to a certain age. I'm not gonna say why, but anyway. See, every day we need to go out and do this. This is black eyed peas, the yellow tan hulls, and these are purple hull peas, and all the others. And the purple hull is the purple hull peas. See, some of these are questionable. Most, I'd say about 85% of the purple hulls are the way they should be. They should be like this right here. Well, this is still kind of moist. But you see this one? This one here, this one's been on the paper, though. It's dried out. Purple hull peas is a really good southern dish, which has become popular over the last 10 years or so, too, by the way. Oh, purple hull peas, oh, yeah, we've had those, you know. When I was in Chicago growing up in the 70s, people never even heard of purple hull peas. But down here, look at how big these are. These are about 9 inches, 10 inches long. One pod. I don't know if I can use a comparison for anything. Here's this chess, glass chess or checkerboard thing. It's as long as that is. So that might be a 10-inch square. So it's about 10 inches each, this pod. Most of them are real long like that. Whew, man, it's not hot out here. They're saying 60% chance of rain today and 70 tomorrow and then 60% chance of rain. Yeah, it's just, they don't know. I guess I go off on a rant about all the chemtrails and how they've messed the jet stream completely up. And but yeah, over there is our beans, peas. Plus I've planted some various beans, you know, in the garden that are coming up. I planted them about a week ago, roughly. Mid-July is like the second planting, if any, of beans or peas. Well, not peas. Peas are a cool weather. You could probably plant those maybe about mid-August, late August, so you have September and October. Down here, it stays temperate. It has. Like I said, with the jet stream being changed from the chemical spraying and such, it used to be like September would start cooling down. October, it's cool. November, it's starting to get cool still, but not cold. Then December would be cold. January, real cold. February, real cold. Then it start warming up again. But because of man God messing with the weather, with the chemtrails and spraying all that stuff up there, the jet streams are so messed up. Look at my sunflowers. They should look like this in September, about October, right around October. But look at them now. See if I can get the ones on the back row back there. You see how they look now? Okay. And I'm not a horticulturist or, by anybody's definition, a knowledgeable gardener. But you look behind that. There's about 150 acres of Monsanto cotton, which they sprayed yesterday. They spray about once a week with one of the most toxic concoctions they can, is the cotton that gets sprayed with. And like I said, my sunflowers have been looking like this because they do it weekly, by the way, just so you know. We're out in the middle of the open like this. The winds blow that stuff and it drifts. So, again, Monsanto, creator of DDT, napalm, Agent Orange, they're going to control your food. That's what they said. They're going to control all the food, the world's food supply. So think about that for a minute, okay? They're real good with poisons and toxins. And that's what's going to control the food and the cotton that you're going to have on your body. Oh, Jesus. I'm sorry. GMO, I don't give a shit if they say it's proven or not. It's not. You know, 20 years from now, they don't know what the long-term repercussions are regardless. But it can't be possible because nature is as close to perfect as can be. And for a man to say he can do better, well, you leave that alone for the stupid people. And those that just don't know. Well, see, there's ignorant people who don't know better and stupid people who have been given the knowledge and the information and still say the same conclusion, which has been proven wrong, like Hillary Clinton. Oh, yeah, she's guilty as hell, but we're not going to prosecute. That's your stupid people. So, there you go. Happy birthday, Tracy. bean peas, black eyed peas, and purple hull peas. And this is just one of about five or six different times, so I'm just letting them dry out thoroughly on this paper out here. These should be out here earlier in the morning because the sun comes right across, you know, in the eastern sky, and the sun comes right onto this. Oh, here's for all my the diehards out there that want to be left alone. If you can read that, I can't read it with this right now. The Constitution is the law of this nation. Suspension of the Constitution is illegal as well as unconstitutional. Any unconstitutional orders such as listed here but not limited only to the confiscation of any firearms, martial law, revocation of the Second Amendment, detainment of any person is to be considered an act of treason, and those that would issue such order as considered a traitor, because I got glare on here now. And those that would issue such order be considered a traitor to the Constitution as well as to the nation and immediately arrested. The Constitution of the United States of America is the supreme law of the land. You swore an oath to uphold and defend that document and its values therein against all enemies, both foreign as well as domestic. Okay? We are a constitutional republic, not a democracy. I wanted to use some expletives with that, but you know, there's too many weak-minded fools that would probably soil themselves if I did. But, there you go.